Welcome to this week's edition of K-Double's Fifth Period Music Class. That's right, right here on Four Aces Presents tonight. Myself, K-Double, will be taking you on a musical journey, something that you can tell your mama about and be proud. So sit back, buckle up, and listen in as K-Double introduces you to his Fifth Period Music Class.
The following Four Aces production is for mature audiences only. Listener discretion is highly advised.
Y'all know what it is. Katy Perry, Juicy J. Let's rave.
I knew you were gonna come to me.
And here you are,
but you better choose carefully.
Cause I'm
capable of anything, and everything.
Make me your Aphrodite. Make me your
What? turn it up cause it's getting heavy. Wild, wild, West Coast. These are the girls I love the most. I mean the ones, I mean like she's the one. Kiss her, touch her, squeeze her bones. The girl's afraid she drive a Jeep and live on the beach. I'm okay, I won't play, I love the bay. Just like I love LA, Venice Beach and Palm Springs. Summertime is everything, homeboys banging out. All that ass hanging out. Bikinis, bikinis, martinis, no weenies. Just the king and the queen. Katy, my lady. Look at here, baby. I'm all up on you, cause you represent me.
First and foremost, what is up, y'all? How are y'all doing this evening? Hope that nice pump and thumping start to this show made you happy there. As you can see, today's artist of the week is the one, the only, the lovely Miss Katy Perry. We opened up with her song Dark Horse with Juicy J off of the Prism album, which is just a slapper. Then with Last Friday Night off of her Teenage Dream album. Hot and Cold, which was my ringtone for a little bit at one point, off of One of the Boys from 2008, and then California Girls, as you just heard, with Snoop Dogg off the album California Girls in 2010. All of those tracks hot and ranked somewhere within the top 100 at some point during their existence. Sorry, pardon me. It's Catherine Elizabeth Hudson. Born October 25th, 1984. She's actually 7 years younger than me. Known professionally as Katy Perry, is an American singer, songwriter, and television judge. After singing in church during her childhood, she pursued a career in gospel music as a teenager. Perry signed with Red Hill Records and released her debut studio album, Katy Hudson, under her birth name in 2001, which was commercially unsuccessful. She moved to Los Angeles the following year to venture... venture into secular music. After Red Hill ceased operations, she subsequently began working with producers Glenn Ballard, Dr. Luke, and Max Martin. After adopting the stage name Katy Perry and being dropped by the Island Def Jam Music Group and Columbia Records, she signed a recording contract with Capitol in April of 07. Perry rose to fame in 08 with her second album, One of the Boys, a pop rock record containing the singles I Kissed the Girl and Hot and Cold. The former track also sparked controversy for its themes of lesbianism. Her third album, Teenage Dream, ventured into disco and was her first record to top the U.S. Billboard 200. It peaked at number one on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 with the singles California Girls, as you just heard, Teenage Dream, which you'll hear later on tonight, Firework, E.T., and Last Friday Night, which you just heard. And you'll actually hear Firework and E.T. as well. While The One That Got Away, which you'll hear tonight, reached number three on the chart, the album became the first by a female artist to produce five number one songs in the U.S., and the second overall after Michael Jackson's Bad. In 2012, Perry reissued the album as Teenage Dream, the complete collection, which produced the songs Part of Me and Wide Awake. Her next record was Prism in 2013, which became her second to top the U.S. charts. It is influenced by pop and dance, and she became the first artist with multiple videos to reach a billion views on Vevo. The videos for the songs Roar and Dark Horse. She followed this. She followed with 2017's Witness, which delved into electropop and became her third album to chart at number one in the U.S. Chained to Rhythm was the album's most successful single, breaking Spotify's record at the time for most first day streams for a song by a female artist. Those are interesting records. Perry has received various awards, including the four Guinness World Records, 5 Billboard Music Awards, 5 Music Awards, 5 American Music Awards, a Brit Award, a Juno Award, and 13 Grammy nominations. She has been included in the annual Forbes list of highest earning women in music from 2011 to 2019. Her estimated net worth as of 2016 is $125 million. She is one of the world's best-selling music artists, has sold over 18 million albums and 125 million singles worldwide. In film, she released an autobiographical documentary titled Katy Perry, Part of Me in 2012, and voiced Smurfette in the 2011 film The Smurfs and its sequel in 2013. Perry also began serving as a judge on American Idol in 2018. So that's what she's been up to. So now to get back to the music, we're going to hear another block of Katy Perry, of course, because that's our artist of the week. Starting off with that hot hit that we talked about, the controversial hit, I Kissed a Girl, off of her One of the Boys albums in 2008. Teenage Dream, off Teenage Dream album in 2010. And This Is How We Do, off the Prism album in 2013. We're going to go to listen to a podcast promo and then come back and listen to Rise, her single from 2016, Waking Up in Vegas, her single from 2009, Small and Small Talk, her single in 2019, her most recent single in 2019. Then we'll come back with 10 things you may not have known about Katy Perry. Y'all, I hope y'all enjoying listening. You are listening to KD5P right here on the Forex Presents Radio Network, Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, and wherever you find your favorite podcasts.
chic at La Superica, grabbing tacos, checking out hotties. Now we're talking astrology, getting our nails did all Japanese. Day drinking at the Wildcat, sucking real bad at Mariah Carey. Last night's dress. I see you. Yo, this goes out to all you kids that still have their cars at the club valet, and it's Tuesday. Yo, shout out to all you kids buying bottle service with your rent money. Respect! This is how we do.
Interruption in progress. Now hijacking into ANS 2.0 immersion rig. Now simulating the amazing nerd show. Featuring comics.
And Batman's like, you're safe here and everything, but the Joker all of a sudden pulls out a gun and shoots himself.
Movies.
People fight with lightsabers. What the hell do you want? I mean, in every one of these movies, there's a lightsaber battle.
Yeah, no problem. I'm going to rewatch it a million times.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, give me something more.
Wrestling.
That would be awesome. Oh my god. Just a monster. Fans would be like, holy, what the hell's going on? What happened to Jericho?
Horror.
It starts off like any other like home invasion type of story, and then it just goes crazy.
And more.
Hey, this is Christian.
Hey, this is Dan.
And we are the Amazing Nerd Show.
Make sure to download us on all your favorite podcast platforms.
I won't just survive. Oh, you will see me thrive. Can't write my story. I'm beyond the archetype. I won't just conform. No matter how you shake my core, 'cause my roots, they run deep. Oh, oh yeah, so little faith. Don't doubt it, don't doubt it. Victory is in my veins. I know it.
I must stay conscious through the madness and chaos. So I call on my angels. They say, oh, you have so little faith.
Shake the ground. Isn't it strange that you used to know me? All the highs and lows and in-betweens, and now you see me and just say, hey. Isn't it weird that you see me naked? We had conversations about forever, now it's about the weather, okay? And I just can't believe we went from strangers to lovers to strangers in a lifetime. Now just memories, we've gone from strangers to lovers to strangers. Yeah. Acting like we never met, faking like we just forget we were lovers, and now there's nothing left but small talk. Had to be into your skin, there's no your hands haven't been. Ain't it funny, cause now there's nothing left but small talk. Isn't it wild that I know your weakness, and everybody at the party thinks that you're the best since sliced bread. And isn't it awkward, I gotta know somebody, and honestly I'll probably be a while before we can just be friends. Acting like we never met, faking like we just forget we were lovers, and now there's nothing left but small talk. Had to be into your skin, there's no your hands haven't been. Ain't it funny, cause now there's nothing left but small talk. Blah 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 blah, blah 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 blah, blah 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 blah. Now there's nothing left but small talk. Blah blah blah. Acting like we never met, faking like we just forget we were lovers, and now there's nothing left.
All right, that there was Miss Katy Perry with Small Talk, lovely song off of her most, one of her more recent albums in 2019, or her most recent album in 2019. I believe the album was called Small Talk, but I'm not 100% sure about my album names this particular show. But what was I going to say? That was a great block. Started off with I Kissed a Girl, then off of One of the Boys in 2008, then you got Teenage Dream from 2010, This Is How We Do off of Prism in 2013, then you got Rise, a very beautiful song from 2016, and then Waking Up in Vegas, a very fun song that I discovered thanks to America's Best Dance Crew from 2009, and then Small Talk from 2019. Now, on to what I promised you for this block, which is 10 things you may not know about Katy Perry. Well, what I just told you was one of them. Her name, her real name is Katherine Elizabeth Hudson. Although she recorded her first album under the name Katie Hudson in 2001, the singer adopted the moniker Katy Perry for future albums. Reportedly, she did it so in order to avoid confusion with the actress Kate Hudson. Perry is her mother's maiden name. There you go. Second, she's a brunette. Perry is known for changing her hair color frequently, so you might be surprised to find out that the singer's original hair color is a light to medium brown. She goes, I'm naturally most boring dishwasher squirrel brown. She says so she's been playing with color since she was like 15, she told Glamour. She loves amusement parks. In an interview with Vogue, Perry described herself as an amusing park junkie, and she has a particular fondness for Disneyland. She's a member of Disneyland's exclusive Club 33, a VIP-only restaurant and club. She has proven herself to be a true Disney lover by dressing up as characters like Cinderella, Snow White, and Minnie Mouse in the past. She wears a uniform to discourage the paparazzi. When she's performing on stage or walking a red carpet, Katy Perry is known for wearing extravagant clothing. However, in her normal life, the singer often wears the same Adidas tracksuit every time she leaves her home to discourage the paparazzi from taking her photo. Supposedly, wearing the same outfit all the time makes the picture less interesting and sellable. Interesting. Her childhood's next up is her childhood celebrity was JTT, Jonathan Taylor Thomas. As a kid, Perry had a crush on teen idol Jonathan Taylor Thomas, who starred on 90s TV sitcom Home Improvement. It seems like the torch she carried for him hasn't dimmed, even as an adult. Because in 2009, the singer tweeted, "Where in the world is Jonathan Taylor Thomas? I loved you, JTT." contrary to rumors, Scarlett Johansson was not Perry's muse. Although internet rumors often point to actress Scarlett Johansson as being the inspiration behind Perry's song, I Kissed a Girl, the singer has revealed that the tune is actually about a girl she met when she was 17. The singer claims that she never kissed Johansson, and Miley Cyrus apparently thinks the song is about her. Okay. Next up is an interesting fact of that she's never won a Grammy. Despite 13 nominations, Perry has never won a Grammy Award. However, the singer doesn't seem to think awards matter. All the award shows are fake, and all the awards that I've won are fake, she told the New York Times. Wow. Next up is that she dropped out of high school at the ripe age of 15. Perry dropped out of school in order to focus on singing. However, it's a decision she now regrets. I'm kind of bummed at this stage that I didn't have a great education, because I could really use that these days, she told Yahoo in 2014. The next fact is she has two siblings, a younger brother named David and an older sister named Angela. They're like the Three Musketeers, actually the Three Stooges, she said, of them in an interview with Harper's Bazaar. She feels really blessed because of where she came from. And then finally, she believes in aliens. She believes in aliens, Perry. I believe in aliens, Perry told GQ in 2014. I look up into the stars and I imagine how self-important are we to think that we're the only life form. I mean, if my relationship with Obama gets any better, I'm going to ask him that question. It just hasn't been appropriate yet. All right, so that's a quote from her. All right, so I got those factoids from www.simplemost.com. The article "Things You Never Knew About Katy Perry" by Margot Bloch Klein. September 10th, 2018. So, just so you know where I got that from. All right. So, next up, we got a 3-song block with Katy Perry, and then one of Katy Perry's idols and one of my favorite artists that we actually already done recently, but I wanted to play a couple more songs of her because she was a direct inspiration to Katy Perry's Madonna. We got "Crazy for You" and "Justify My Love" after the commercial break, but we got 3 more songs coming. The One That Got Away, "Roar" and "Firework." I saved the last two because they're 2 of her more popular songs. All right, y'all, enjoy. Thank you for listening in. Keep listening in all week. We got Mr. Deacon's Experience tomorrow. We've got Cheap Pop, hopefully West Coast Bias. We've got on Sunday, we've got Inspire Radio, Brick House, Now Versus Then, all running on the network right now. Miss Toy on Thursday nights, listen to her. Guys, we got a great lineup. Y'all should be listening to them all already if you're listening to this track and this song. Sorry, player.
Summer after high school, when we first met, we make out in your Mustang to Radiohead. And on my 18th birthday, we got matching tattoos. Used to steal your parents' liquor and climb to the roof. Talk about a future like we had a clue. Never planned that one day
plastic bag. Drifting through the wind, wanting to start again. Do you ever feel so paper thin? Like a house of cards, one blow from caving in.
So, what's up? Steve Finger Styles here, the host of the podcast, spelled D-A, of course. Tune in each and every week to hear what pisses me off, what angers me, what I make fun of, and of course, my crazy rants. I also have incompetent co-hosts, cool guests, and a silent producer that sucks. So what more do you need from a podcast? You can listen on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, TuneIn, SoundCloud, and the Pod Bros Network. Peace.
All right, so like I promised you, we're going to listen to a small block of Madonna before we get back with a hardcore West Coast rap song that I want you to hear. Next up is Crazy For You off the Vision Quest album in 1985, and Justify My Love off the Immaculate Collection in 1990 from the one and only, the incomparable Miss Madonna, one of Katy Perry's biggest inspirations, as said by Katy Perry herself. So, hope you guys enjoy this. You are listening to KD5P right here on the 4X Presents Radio Network, Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, and wherever you find your favorite podcasts.
Just making the most of the dark. Two by two, their bodies become one. I see you through the smoky air. Can't you feel the weight of my stare? You're so close.
Two are standing still in time. If you for you to justify my love.
From the galactic depths of the comic book universe comes the Ghosts of the Stratosphere, ready to galvanize and energize your mind with the latest of comic book news and reviews. And why are you stopping me?
Yes, that's much better. Hi, this is Andy Larson for Ghosts of the Stratosphere. Join me every week along with my co-hosts Rob Stewart and Chad Smith, as well as a cavalcade of fantastic comic book guests, as we dish out heaping helpings of the greatest and latest of comic book news and reviews. New shows posted every Tuesday with bonus shows every first Friday of the month. You can find us on iTunes and Stitcher under Ghosts of the Stratosphere, as well as on our website www.gotstratosphere.com. Hope to see you soon, folks.
All right. So you heard it there. Go check out the guys over at gotstratosphere.com. Ghost of Stratosphere there on the promo preview. All right. So last song is always a song, is almost always a song I want you to hear, or whatever happened to tonight. It's a song I want you to hear along with EDM track of the week. The song I want you to hear this week is from 1992 by the one and only Dr. Dre and Snoop Diggity 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 Dogg at a time which hit when hip-hop, or not hip-hop, but gangster rap and rap in general was just hitting the scene. Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre, nothing but a G thing. We're going to close it out with Nobody Rules the Streets by Bronski and Louisa from 2012. And we'll see y'all next week for another Billboard. Last week we did the 90s. This week we might do the 80s or the 2000s. I haven't quite made up my mind. But we'll see you back for another KD5P next week until the sports world gets going again or something interesting happens. That probably won't be a K or Double K's Classroom for a minute. So, all right, y'all. Thanks for listening. Peace.
To the folks, Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre is at the door, ready to make an entrance, so back on up,
cause you know we're about to rip shit up.
Give me the microphone first so I can bust like a bubble. Compton and Long Beach together, now you know you in trouble. Ain't nothing but a G thing, baby. Too low death niggas, so we're crazy. Death Row is the label that pays me. Unfadable, so please don't try to fake this. But back to the lecture at hand. Perfection is perfected, so I'ma let them understand. From a young G's perspective, and before me dig out a bitch, I have to find a contraceptive. You never know, she could be earning her man and learning her man, and at the same time burning her man. Now you know I ain't with that shit, Lieutenant. Ain't no pussy good enough to get burned while I'm offended. And that's realer than real deal, holy feel. And now you hookers and hoes know how I feel. Well, if it's good enough to get broke off a proper chunk, I take a small piece of some of that funky stuff. It's like this and like that and like this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this and like that and like this and Drake creep to the mic like a fan.
Well, I'm beeping and I'm creeping and I'm creeping, but I damn near got caught. My beeper kept beeping. Now it's time for me to make my impression felt. So sit back, relax, and strap on your seatbelt. You've never been on a ride like this before. With a producer who can rap and control the maestro. At the same time with the dope rhyme that I kick. You know and I know I flow some old funky shit. To add to my collection, this selection symbolizes dope. Take a toke, but don't choke. If you do, you have no clue of what me and my homie Snoop Dogg came to do.
It's like this and like that and like this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this.
And who gives a fuck about those?
So just chill to the next episode. What a hell of a gangster lean. Getting funky on the mic like an old batch of collard greens. It's the capital S-O-S of fresh and double O-P. D-O-double-G-Y-D-O-double-G, you see. Showing much flex when it's time to wreck a mic. Pimping hoes and clocking a grip like my name was Dolomite. Yeah, and it don't quit. I think they in the mood for some motherfucking G shit.
Hell yeah.
So Drake,
what up, dog?
Gotta give them what they want.
What's that, G?
We gotta break them off something.
Hell yeah.
And it's gotta be bumping. City of Compton.
It's where it takes place, so we'll gnash your attention. Mobbing like a motherfucker, but I ain't lynching. Dropping the funky shit that's making the sucker niggas mumble. When I'm on the mic, it's like a cookie, they all crumble. Try to get close, and your ass will get smacked. My motherfucking homie, Doggy Dogg, has got my back. Never let me slip, cause if I slip, then I'm slipping. But if I got my Nina, then you know I'm straight tripping. And I'ma continue to put the rap down, put the Mac down. And if your bitches talk shit, I have to put the smack down. Yeah, and you don't stop. I told you I'm just like a clock when I tick and I talk. But I'm never off, always on till the break of dawn. See you when PTO went in the city they call Long Beach. Putting the shit together like my nigga DOC. No one can do it better
like this. That and this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this.
Then who gives a fuck about those?
So just chill till the next episode.
cruise the streets. Nobody rules the streets at night like me. Nobody rules these 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 streets at night like me. Me, me, me.
Again, I want to thank you for listening in to this week's edition of K-Double's Fifth Period Music Class. I hope y'all have a great night, and be sure to tune in to Planet of Coal this week, version one, right here.